Introduce yourself if you would.
All right. My name is Jamie Smith, and I'm the radiation safety officer for Amarillo College. I also teach radiography, so I have my own dosimeter as well. I just got out of lab. So a dosimeter is what records your radiation dosage. You cannot attend clinicals without it. Okay. It comes in a package separate from your class, and it just clicks in the holder, and then you will wear it on your collar. Okay? So just click it in, and then you can turn the back on your badge so that it's hanging however you want it to hang. And you're going to wear it at collar level when you go to clinicals.
That's actually important, the level where you wear it at.
Yes, it is. Y'all wear lead aprons?
No.
Well, never have to wear lead aprons.
But
if you were ever to wear a lead apron, you would need to put make sure that your dosimeter is outside the lead apron so that it can track the radiation that your thyroid and your eyes are getting, especially. These are very sensitive. Of course, there's radiation just in the atmosphere naturally, so you want to do your best to protect your dosimeter from getting radiation exposure that is unnecessary from the sun. Please don't leave your dosimeters on the dash of your car. Don't run it through the washer and dryer by leaving it clasped onto your scrubs. What else could?
Any excessive
heat source.
Yeah.
Just don't try not to keep it near any heat source. Don't leave it in your purse, in your car. So be sure when you take it off when you're leaving clinicals that you put in something that you're going to be taking inside the house with you. I always clasp mine inside my purse so when it's sitting in the car seat, it's not being exposed to the sun directly.
What about cold sources? Is that an issue?
I've never had a radiation exposure from a cold source. Under no circumstances will you ever radiate someone's badge. If you see your next door neighbor had it on his lab coat and he took his lab coat off to go to lunch and you think, oh, I'm gonna be cute and go put that in the room and give it a huge radiation dose, that's a big no-no. And of course I tell you that because it's happened before. They thought it was really cute, really funny, and stacks of paperwork had to be filled out because of that. So you won't ever have any reason to touch anyone else's dosimeter. Your dosimeter is your dosimeter, and that's the only one that you'll ever wear. We change these out every 2 months. I get them in the mail. Tony will forward them to the out-of-town students, but he'll give the local students theirs. You'll just take the old one out, put the new one in, throw the trash away. We don't need that, even though it's got your name on it, I think. Just put the new one in and wear it. And
send us back the old one.
Send us back the old one, absolutely. If you're out of town, send us back the old one as quickly as possible. We send those in and they send us back a reading on how much radiation exposure you had during that 2 month period. And we will be sending those reports out to the distant students. So if you've gotten too much radiation exposure for some reason, there will be some forms that you have to fill out for that. But we hope that you will use good radiation protection and not experience that.
We always tell them don't travel with it. Like, don't go to the airport with it if you can absolutely skip taking it with you. Don't wear it through the x-ray machine. And watch when you go get dental work done. You know, a lot of times, we're going to take back wing x-rays real quick. And you forget you've got it clicked to the top of your shirt, and they take your x-rays. You're going to get some dust from that. So,
yeah, so never, if you are having your own personal medical x-ray, don't wear your dosimeter.
No.
This is only to measure any student job-related exposure.
Right.
Any questions?
So you're the radiation safety officer. What does that mean?
That means that I monitor. I'm the one who sends in the badges. They send me back the reports, and I go through the reports and make sure that no one in any of the Amarillo College programs has gotten too much radiation exposure. If they have, they have to come to my office for counseling and sign some forms explaining what happened, why the radiation dose is too high, and how it's you're going to keep it from happening again. So
and that's only happened with radiation therapy students twice in my 26 years. Once was when we were doing a lab, and a student had their dosimeter badge on their backpack, which they put on the table where the machine was pointed at all afternoon.
Oh my goodness.
26,700 milligrams, I remember. That's a lot of paperwork.
Wow.
And then the other time was actually there was a, when the new x-ray equipment was put in the lab over here, the where the badges were kept was getting some scattered dose. So in neither case, students were not actually getting dose. So radiation therapy is actually very safe. And one of the ways we prove it's safe is by taking these measurements. Any questions? All right.
All right. Good
Thank you, Jane.
Your career.
Thank you. Thank you.